Hello guys, this video is made for giving introduction to Wipro Talent Next training program. I would like to give you the detailed schedule of our training program. So let me share my screen. I hope this screen is visible to you. And this is the schedule that we have already submitted to Wipro Talent Next. So meeting these end dates is mandatory. So you must be able to complete all the topics and the assignments under that particular topics within the stipulated date is mandatory. And let me first show you how to log in and how the typical PBL app will be. And PBL stands for Project Based Learning. And this is the home page of the PBL app. So this is the IP address. I hope you all have received through your mails. Make sure that the whatever the mail you have given, it will be active as long as you are going to continue the training as well as you are going to be associated with the Wipro Talent Next program. So this will be the home page. And as soon as you click this login, you will be asked to enter your ID. I hope you all remember your Synergy resume IDs. So you need to give that Synergy resume ID here, and then the password default it is that talentnext@123 for everyone. And later after you log in, you can update your password as well. And this will be the home page. Once you log in, this will be the home page. Here you can see your name being displayed, and then what are the topics we are going to cover. The same topics we have already seen in this schedule as well. As per this particular topics only, you can see in the PBL app as well. The same topics you will be seeing. And whenever you click on particular topic, you will be getting the screen like this. And currently, all over the country, there were 30,000 students undergoing this training from various institutes. So that is the reason you might be facing a little downtime with this app. You have to bear with it, no other options. And whenever you click on one particular topic, and this is the screen of Oops or Inheritance. And if I click this Oops or Inheritance, there you can see exercises altogether there are 17. And when you click a particular topic, you can see the expansion coming like this. And it's nothing to grade. It's nothing to grade. It's only for self-exercising purpose and self-preparation purpose. What you are supposed to do is you are supposed to go through these materials and all the mandatory PDFs, whatever you see as part of every topic, they are exclusively Wipro content. They are exclusively Wipro content. So apart from that, in addition to that, they have also provided other resources in form of links. You can just click on those links and you can go through them. And once you feel that you are confident enough with that particular topic, what you need to do is you just need to come on to these hands-on assignments. And once you come on to these hands-on assignments, here you can read the exercise and you can just build it and then execute it and check for yourself. And once you are done doing those exercises, what you need to do is you just need to click these checkboxes under the status and click on update completion status. Once you click this update completion status, then you can see this exercises being updated. And this is how you can see. And as part of the topics, whatever you are going to study through, there you can see logic building exercises. Here you can see logic building our plan M1, logic building our plan M2A, logic building our plan M2B. So when you click them, you will be getting a document opened, and there you can see some exercises, and all the Wipro assessments are going through from the Mettle platform. So Mettle is one of the online platform where you can perform your tests. And here you can see this is one of the link what I have opened. This is one of the link which is to test for EaseEven program. And once you click this launch test, so this is how the test will be loaded. It just takes some time. And one thing you need to remember is Here, once the test is loaded and when you click on next and when you click on proceed, here it will be asking you for these details, and it's not mandatory that you will be filling all these details. Since all these are for practice purpose only, you can just fill in these four details which are marked as asterisk, that is email address, first name, employee ID, location. And one thing what you need to understand is whatever the email address you are giving, it need not be exact. And whatever the email address for once you give, it will be submitted with that email address. And next time, if you give the same email address for the same question, it will not permit you. So you can just give any other email ID like this. So you can see what I am doing here. I have just given something. And it's only for practice purpose. Why I'm asking you to give any other email address as well is because once you open the question and the timer gets started, and if you are unable to complete that particular problem within that stipulated time, then you will not be able to again execute it with the same email address. That's the reason I'm just giving like this. And here you can see, and employee ID, you can just give something. And then here you can just give some location, and then by clicking this checkbox you can just click on next. And here once you click on this start test, here you can see, and you can just click on this end tour, and there here you can see that on the left side of the panel you can see the description of the problem, and here you can see the console part where you can just type the code. And here you can do the language selection. It's not mandatory that you are going to solve them with Java itself, or whichever language you are comfortable with, you can just choose that particular language. And then here you can see the editor is being loaded since I have changed my platform. So it just takes little time. Yeah. Now it's ready. So what you need to do is you just need to understand this question carefully, and then you need to start building your code. And here you will be writing your code, and then when you are done writing the code, you will be doing this compile and test, and then it will give you the result whether it is passed or failed. It just takes time. Here you can see for input -4 expected result is 2, and like this you can just understand that from the error description, and you can just here again go back to your code, and you can just correct your code and do that. Here you can see the time being ticked, so you need to make sure that within this time you will be able to complete all the test cases being passed. I think many of you might have been already used to such kind of platforms. So results, it will be showing only the primary test cases. Here you can see the expected whatever the inputs being passed. Once these results get passed, then you will be having some private test cases. So the private test cases are hidden, which are not shown to you. And once you are done with all the test cases, you can click on finish test. And this is why I said it's not mandatory you to give the exact mail ID, because if you give the exact mail ID and if you are unable to finish this test within the stipulated time, then again you can't use the same mail ID. So you need not worry, you can just give any mail ID, and it need not, it will not be even authenticated. It's a genuine mail ID or valid or invalid mail ID, and nothing will be checked. So you just need to give something with @gmail.com, something like that, and name, you can give any name. It's only for practice purposes. These all are practice purposes, but the thing you need to understand is your final assessments will be all your assessments in between the training program and your final assessment, everything will be in this Mettle platform. So the MCQ test, whatever you are going to write, and the logical building exercises, whatever you are going to do, everything will be from this Mettle platform. And another thing you need to understand here is when you have started your test, suppose if I'm going to another window, when I come back here, you can see sometimes you will be given warning saying that you are not supposed to navigate the window. And first time it might give warn you, and next time if you still try to move or leave away from the window, immediately your test will be submitted. So make sure that once you start the test, you don't leave it until you submit the code, and then click on finish test. Then you can see the result will be displayed to you. And if you want, you can even click to see the report. Something like this it will be producing. If it is a MCQ based test, it will even produce this report where it shows you what kind of concepts you are familiar with, what kind of concepts you need preparation, all that it will be showing like this. So this is the Mettle platform you need to understand. So as I mentioned, the four things which you need to give are email, which is not mandatory. Here you can see the email what I have given, and then the name. So email, it has to be always unique. For a particular problem, it has to be a unique mail. And if I want to take this same test, because here I have got 0 marks, so if I want to take the same test, what I have to do is I have to give in different email ID. So just keep these things in mind while you take any test using this Mettle platform for the logic building exercises. And these things you can ignore, and if you are interested, you can just give the feedback. Yeah, as I said, here topic by topic you just go through, and all the mandatory PDFs are of completely Wipro documents, and the other references are for additional materials. And after getting thorough with the concept, you can just go through the hands-on assignments. You can practice them in your own desktops, and once you have executed those hands-on assignments on your desktop, nowhere to upload, you can just click on these check boxes and click on this update completion status, so that in the Wipro server also, under your resume ID, you can see this exercises being updated. And please do not share these credentials with any of your friends. It's exclusively for yourself, and every machine and every IP address will be tracked where your Synergy resume ID is being used. So you just keep in mind all these things before you share anything else. And our training will be based on these particular topics only. Here you can see. So first we get started with the Java fundamentals, and then we discuss the OOPS concepts, and then we'll discuss the Eclipse, and then we will discuss the abstraction packages and exception handling, and then wrapper classes and JUnit. So earlier I have shown you that Mettle tool now. So whatever the expected and actual results you are seeing now, that's using with JUnit only. That's completely using JUnit. So that is how the HackerRank and Mettle and any other online platforms for programming assignments, they'll be using JUnit only for raising those test cases. And then IO streams, and as I mentioned, the assessment milestone one. And here you can see assessment milestone 1, assessment milestone 2 and 3. So these are not enabled for you right now, because as I mentioned, this schedule is already submitted to Wipro. So according to these dates only, they will be enabled. So it's mandatory that you will be scoring minimum of 70% in these assessment milestones. And you need to be familiar with these topics when you are going to appear for this assessment milestone 1. And then we'll be looking at the coding standards, how the industry expects you to write the code. And then we will discuss the collection frameworks. And not all the interfaces and classes we are going to cover as part of collections. We will cover the basic required collections only. And then we will discuss about the multi-threading. And then we will discuss about RDBMS and SQL. It's for JDBC purpose. And whatever the end project you are going to submit also will be based on this JDBC connections only. So you require a minimal knowledge on this RDBMS, SQL and JDBC. and JDBC also we will cover as part of our training, and we'll be using type 4 driver for this JDBC connection, and then you will be going through this assessment milestone too, and after that we'll be covering these topics: ANT, HTML, JavaScript, CSS, servlets and JSP, XML 1 and 2, and finally we will end up this training with Ajax, and you will go through the assessment milestone 3, and later some period of time will be given for your self preparation, and then your final assessment will be there, and your final assessment will be comprising of 3 parts. The first part will be MCQ part, which will be around 1 hour duration, and second part will be logic building exercises. As I have shown you earlier, using the Mettle platform, using the Mettle only you will be doing these 2 parts, and the final will be project. So that will be with the Wipro project server. So there you will be provided a scenario. You need to understand the scenario, and you need to build the classes and interfaces accordingly, and you will be uploading to the Wipro server, where your project will be evaluated, and the test results will be produced, and accordingly you will be given grading, and you need to secure minimum of 75% to get through this certification, and later on the next steps will be taken care by the Wipro. And one thing you need to understand is, it's not a guarantee that if you are going through this training with all the milestones being achieved, and if you are even getting through the certification also, it's not guaranteed that Wipro will be hiring you. These are all the basic steps that you will be undergoing as part of this Wipro Talent Next program, and after you are being certified, then you will be called for the interview, and in the interview they will decide whether they can hire you or not. So the thing you need to understand is, it's all a kind of fresher training program. That means before you get placed into the company, and the company gives you the fresher training, the same training is being provided in your final year. That's what you need to understand. And if not even for Wipro, this training will help you to get hired with other companies. So understand that point, and be prepared, and go through all the exercises, and hope you will be participating effectively in this training, and then you will be able to succeed in the milestones as well. All the best.